WLWT News 5 Today starts now.
Well, good morning. Welcome to News 5 Today. Thanks for joining us on this Sunday morning, first day of September. August.
Yeah,
it
right.
Went so, it went so quickly.
In. Yes, it did.
Here we the countdown's on.
Well,
we got time.
I mean, it's only been 5 hours.
You're right. You're absolutely right. 5 hours of September. It sounds
yes.
like a thriller novel.
It does. It's a good title.
I'm Jonathan Hoggood. This is Jennifer Shack. How
yes.
you doing?
I'm doing great.
Good. Well, you
yes.
are far and away the more important person here today
yes.
as you are monitoring the weather for this Riverfest weekend.
Yesterday's forecast, we talked about the storm chance, and today fewer than yesterday, and I still think that holds very true because, you know, we had a couple of rounds we ended up yesterday with morning thunderstorms
yeah,
that were strong.
Last night.
Evening thunderstorms were almost for everyone that were strong, and as you noted, quite a bit of damage, so I'm sure you'll have that. But
sure.
I do have some of the numbers from yesterday's rainfall as well as the forecast details for today. Ever so important if you're planning for Riverfest. Here's the Power 5 radar. We've had very isolated storms north of the Tri-State along the I-70 corridor during the overnight. So right now, dry conditions for everyone. The rain down by Louisville is sinking south. The thunderstorms to our north are not doing much. They've been dissipating over the last couple of hours. But take a look yesterday afternoon, just before 5 p.m. A complex of storms to the north were diving south, and storms were developing across northern Kentucky. They kind of converged right across the heart of the metro, and that resulted in quite a bit of damage, several severe thunderstorm warnings. Those storms sinking south during the late evening and overnight. Any strong thunderstorm activity in western Kentucky, not going to be a problem for us. And now we have the leftover cloud cover and some isolated showers still out there to our north. So we'll keep a very close eye. If we're going to see development today, I think it's during the late morning and into our midday, and we'll watch that radar. We did have a record rainfall at the Cincinnati International Airport yesterday, 1.58 inches, the previous record back in 2003. And that takes the August rainfall total to 3.69 inches. So we had about 40% of our August rainfall yesterday. We did end up above average for the month. Here's a look at the city cam with the dry conditions right now, but it's still very muggy and we still have some wet pavement and puddles out there from last evening's rainfall. Right now it's 69 degrees, the dew point 68, and the wind out of the east southeast at 3 miles an hour. So our future cast today, a look at some late morning to midday thunderstorms still blossoming. Our cold front is well off to the northwest. It looks like it's close enough to come in today, but it's actually going to wait until tomorrow. It's a slow moving cold front, and ahead of it today we're going to get a little bit of sinking air late for the afternoon into the evening. That's really good news for the fireworks forecast. I think evening chance for stray thunderstorms is mainly heading toward our eastern counties, and then we will see some development along the front tomorrow morning as a few showers and storms refire early on Labor Day. And then late for Labor Day, we dry out as that area of high pressure and some quieter weather arrives late for the evening. And then by Monday night to Tuesday, things were changing our air mass into a much more comfortable scenario and a drier scenario. So our forecast today for Riverfest, if you're heading out, heat indices jumping this afternoon into the mid-90s. The air temperature forecast is 91, but it'll probably feel like 95 or 96 degrees outside. For the rainfall today, a rain coverage on the high end around 30% by the late morning into the early afternoon, and then it actually falls off this evening. By the time the fireworks start, a heat index of 83, only a very stray storm chance, and it looks like mainly our eastern counties. This afternoon we'll top out officially at 91 degrees, a couple of midday thunderstorms, a light southwest wind, and then we actually bring back some activity late tonight into tomorrow morning ahead of that front. We'll end up at 86 on Labor Day afternoon. We'll talk some more about the cooler temperatures beyond that in your 7 day coming up. Jonathan.
Sounds